According to the measure of structural equivalence, a block modeling approach was proposed to classify nodes. The partition consists in building equivalent classes of actors called positions. Such partitions follow two general conditions. First, the partition of actors create discrete subsets called positions, and second, it leads to summarize the relation between pairs of positions. So the notation is the following. We have a partition of I actor of n into b position. The position of I actor to n is a function which attributes a block bk. We build a matrix b by b by r called a block, which is composed of several blocks b, k, l, r, with the presence 1 or absence 0 of xr, which is a relation type between bk and bl. The perfect fit block models occurs if all actors in each position are structurally equivalent. It is 0 for all 0 relation, if all the relation of the block is 0, and 1 if all the relation of the block is 1. This is ideal situation results in the permitted sociomatrix filled with all 1 or all 0. Despite it is quite unlikely that this criterion would be useful in practice, it is an ideal case that can provide a baseline for assessing comparison for tests that are called goodness of fit that we will see in future courses. So, in real network, collection of nodes are rarely structural equivalent. So we have to create rules to determine the assignment of 0 of 1 between positions. The other criteria are 0 block, 1 block, alpha density criteria, and for value data, maximum or mean value. The 0 block criteria defines a relation 0 between two positions only if there are absolutely no relation between individual of these two positions. Otherwise, it is 1. The focus on 0 block is structurally important because of the expectation that while one block might not be completed filled with ones, blocks that contain no observation styles, like these ones, which put 0, they indicate important structural patterns. For example, for geopolitics, interventions, or cooperations, these events do not occur every year. So the apparition of links are rare, and no relation during a long period is an important structural information. In general, this kind of zero block is reasonable if ties are scarce and the network has a very low density. On the opposite, the one block focuses on one value rather than zero. It requires complete field with one in the blocks. Note that in the case that a block is totally connected with himself, it corresponds to a complete subgraph or a clique. So all the ones gives a 1 and the mix gives a 0. Also, densities can be calculated for each couple of blocks and inside each block and be used to assign 0 if the density is lower than the threshold and 1 if the density is higher. So the density is the total number of observed ties divided by all possible. And for inside the block, it is the same. So the density tables between and inside blocks measure the density of blocks of cells. The values in the tables are the ratio of ties of the total possible ties, excepting self ties in the diagonal. For example, the block 1 to the block 2, we have 15 ties out of 24 possible choices. So the density is 0.625. Now, using a threshold of density, one builds an image matrix. This threshold is, for example, the wall density of the matrix, which is 0.452. All the values below are null, and all the highest values are 1. For weighted links, one can use value criteria. The maximum value criteria is analogous to the zero block for dichotomous relations. Blocks that contain only smallest values are defined as zero blocks, and blocks containing some largest values are defined as one block. Another criterion is the mean value. If the mean value of the links between block K and L is greater or equal to the general mean, then the block is defined as a one block. This is analogous to the alpha density of dichotomous relations. Finally, one can examine some few ideal images that display theoretically important structural properties. The cohesive subgroups here correspond to a reflexive position level, so it privileges the diagonal. The center-periphery pattern consists of a core position which is internally cohesive and one or more other positions with ties to the core position, but no each other. In the centralized systems, all ties are pointed toward a single position or from a single position. In the hierarchy, appears as unreciprocal ties directed from each position and the position directly above it in a chain of command. A system is transitive, its position observes transitive rules like this. Depending on the substance of the relation, all these ideal images could indicate dominance or difference between positions. Similarly, to structural equivalence we used here, one can also use regular equivalence in order to build these block matrices.